What's going on, guys? This is your boy Lucid the Rooster back again with another video, and today we are doing another scene analysis. Today we are doing a scene analysis on Cleopatra Jones, and Cleopatra Jones is a cop action genre, which, according to Novotny Lawrence, a cop action drama are police officers intent upon protecting and serving while giving little regard to the rules of his or her profession. And we see this a lot throughout the film with Cleopatra Jones. Is She walks the fine line between the law and vigilantism. It is directed by Jack Starrett, written by Max Julian, Sheldon Keller, and then the story is by Max Julian as well. And it stars Tamara Dobson, Bernie Casey, Brenda Skies, and Shelley Winters, not Shirley Winters, my bad. Cleopatra Jones is about an international police agent who is trying to cut down all the drug usage in her community and throughout the world because it is bad. And she relates it, the way she does this is she first starts off in the poppy field in the establishing shot and then later takes down the don of it, I should say, like the boss of it. And also, according to Novotny Lawrence, that first quote, by the way, was on page 78. This one is on page 84. It is, the appearance of the black female protagonist in a cop action film represents a significant revision to the genre. As previously noted, white males portrayed the heroic protagonist cops in cop films, and significant black male or female representation was severely limited. Well, not severely limited, it's just representation was limited, but knowing with how they were back in the day of hearing the stories, because I'm not old enough to understand or like have lived through it to experience it, but hearing the stories, it would seem like that they are severely limited. But that's just my opinion on it. I don't know entirely, but it is. Now, the scene I'm going to be analyzing for this is when we first meet Mommy, the big big antagonist of the film. And also, according to Novotny Lawrence, now on page 89, is Mommy is the exact opposite of Cleopatra Jones. Mommy is constructed in direct opposition to the black heroine, while Cleopatra Jones is tall, thin, and attractive. Mommy fails to fulfill the mainstream conventions of beauty because she is loud, short, and overweight. Also, another thing with Mommy is that she's kind of like, knowing the history of the LGBTQ community back then, or back in like the 70s, shows that it was not good because they were seen as poison, like gay people were seen as poison, and AIDS and stuff. But, so, it says, Mommy is presented as a sexually charged lesbian whose behavior towards women portrays gay stereotypes. Which is, honestly, a very big win for that entire, the LGBTQ community at the time. Because they didn't really see that type of stuff in the movies that were being made. It was more bad stuff like Poison, to really name off one. It's like, about AIDS and it being poison. Alright, so the scene, like I said, that we are going to be looking at is the scene where we first are introduced to Mommy and her gang, and we can see some of the stuff that I quoted about her being like the lesbian sexual acts and stuff, and how she's loud, short, and overweight. Sorry about that, folks. I kind of wanted to just get the full thing of her yelling, because she starts off the scene very loud and very strong, yelling, "What that bitch?" And then she keeps it going with her anger. And then here you see Evie, her latest quote-unquote bimbo, I'm guessing. Well, not I'm guessing. It's kind of is a bimbo, but yeah. So she comes in already, right away, we know that she's loud and obnoxious. And we can see that she's shorter than everybody, but she still comes in this room powerful, angry, and showing she has power over all of them. And sticking to that stereotype of her being loud, I'm not loud yet, and short, and not the stereotype, but just sticking to it of her being loud.
God damn her, that troublemaking cooth!
Have some brandy, it'll calm your nerves.
Thank you, Eva.
Yep, see, here we can see the lesbian interaction-type thing.
Darling.
That she treats her better than she'll talk to the boys about in like a couple minutes, not even.
You're the only one around here gives a shit about mommy.
See, right there, she just dissed the boys. She doesn't care for them as much as she cares about the girls.
Well, now, as long as she's over there, nothing's gonna get through. I want her.
Now, we also talked in class how mommy represents, at the end of the movie, represents like Hitler in the way she's dressed. To me, that's true as well. But right now, she represents like a villain in the 1960s Batman. Where she's not the smartest, and then her henchmen are brain dead, because a lot of the henchmen back then is very dumb, and which is why I think like I made that first connection of that Cleopatra Jones seems like a vigilante-esque, but yeah, so I feel like these henchmen here are very stupid, and then let's keep watching and see what else we notice.
Black ass back here,
mother, darling. Nobody can make her do anything.
Yeah, my little sweet son, Brucey. You ever heard of the B&S house? Her own little private synanon?
Yes, mother.
Well, if something were to happen to her own little pet charity, she'd be on the next plane back here. Hey, that's it. That is it!
The music in the background now also resembles like that 1963, just or like the cop genre music. You can tell it seems like it would be in a vigilante-esque movie. Like that's a theme for something that would be in like for the bad guy of a vigilante movie. And it's very apparent. Also, you can see here her chair that she's sitting on, the prop right here of her chair, is bigger than everything basically in the house. It's grand. It looks royal, showing that she's the queen and she's the boss. Alright, let's rewind back and.
Bitch! How dare she mess around with my puppies! My god, everybody!
Alright, this we already talked about.
Lion!
Here we get a good look at her costuming though. That.
Bitch! That goddamn black bitch!
Keep going. Sorry, let me just. Wanted to redo that.
Mess
here we get a look at her costuming, and she is very in black, red, and white. Obviously, which would be the same as the Nazi colors that we talked about in class. Or, well, not that we didn't talk about that, but that's just what they had. They had like the really black suits, like in Star Wars. And she has the red and the white that would be on the swastika flag. She has the stick or beating stick. Well, now we see it's blue, but in the lighting, it looked more black, but it's navy blue. She has a cape. What seems like a cape, but just that. And then we see Evie here. She is dressed up in very pink, and pink I assume is going to represent the bimbo aspect of it. So she is representing her bimbo aspect of it and not being up in there. But with this line here, you can see $30 million up in smoke. You can see she is not happy. She is angry, and that's why she comes in screaming loud.
$3 million up in smoke! God damn, are that troublemaking clothes!
And we can see here a little bit of more of her personality, that she's kind of reckless with her anger, is with her hitting that with the stick she has. She's reckless with it, and then Eve obviously calms her down.
Have some brandy, it'll calm your nerves.
Thank you, Eva, darling. You're the only one around here gives a shit about mommy.
And her saying this gives us a reaction from her henchmen, where they're like, oh my gosh, she's not even doing anything.
Well, now...
So we see their reaction.
She's over there!
And as she's walking, sorry, I need to keep pausing. Pausing it so I can talk about it, and it's not as loud. So she's walking over here again. And then...
I want her black ass.
So we have right here this red thing, and it sticks out from everything else around it because it's just everything else is just brown, and it's just like... It's red, so it's going to draw your attention to it because red is like anger, and you're going to notice a color that, like that in a brown and white and gray area. So it seems like it has like swords on it, so showing that she is one not to steer away from violence, where if she needs to get something done, mommy, that is, if mommy needs something done, she will go all in to do it. And then we hear that when she's calling the cops, or like talk about her plan.
Back here.
Mother, darling, nobody can make her do anything.
And like I said, the prop of her chair, it just shows expensive royalty, so she's the queen of the house.
Yeah, my little sweet son, Brucey. You ever heard of the B&S house? Her own little private...
Now, we can see... Once it loads.
You ever heard of the B&S house? Her own...
This guy right here, he's just practicing his weaponry. It looks like he's practicing his weaponry. He's not really aiming at anything. We can say that he's tired of mommy's abuse and just aiming at mommy and doesn't really, sorry about that, care about her as much as she thinks he does. And he could also be pointed at Eve being like, you're getting all this attention, we're getting nothing. Help us out.
Own little private sitting on?
Yes, mother.
Now, like I said, Eve is in like the pink bimbo slutty look. So now where they're her henchmen, they are all in suits. They're nice. Probably suits that mommy bought them, which is how they got them. And they're showing to be the villains of like a mob boss. So mommy is like that quote unquote mob boss dealing all the drugs and having the corruption with the cops and stuff. Which it goes back to mommy sitting in that royalty chair of her being the boss.
Darling, nobody can make her do anything.
Yeah, my little sweet son, Brucey. You ever heard of the B&S house? Her own little private sitting on?
Yes, mother.
Well, if something were to happen to her own little pet Charity, she'd be on the next plane back here. Hey, that's it. That is it!
Now, all the men in the shot, all her henchmen, look at her with some confusion. And we can see it, like, right here with these two look at each other. And he just looked at her. Before she started calling, he was like, what are you talking about? That is not a good idea. But so these two are going to look at each other and be like, she is screwing up right here. We'll see in a second. See, he eyes him on the couch, and then he looks back and he's like, I don't know, man. I don't know. I can't say anything because she will kill me otherwise if I do.
Mommy's speaking.
And then we go to that. So. That is all. Hope you guys did enjoy. Hit that like button down below if you did. And I will see you guys next time. It's your boy, Lucy the Rooster, signing off. Deuces.